Let's begin in New York. Robert F. Kennedy Jr., election and environmental attorney, a supporter of Barack Obama, and co-author of a new Rolling Stone article, Block the Vote. Will the GOP's campaign to deter new voters and discard Democratic ballots determine the next president? They see the cover of the issue that Mr. Kennedy's article appears. And in Los Angeles, Michael Reagan, talk radio host, The Michael Reagan Show. His website is The Reagan Exchange at Reagan.com, a supporter of John McCain. Colin Powell's going on Meet the Press Sunday. Is he going to endorse anyone, Robert? And if so, who?
I don't know.
That's simply put. Okay, Michael, what do you think?
You know, what I think is he probably will support Barack Obama. And I think he would support Barack Obama because he's felt dissed by the Republican Party and by George Bush because of the whole thing with Iraq. And so he's felt that he has been wronged. And probably because of that, he is going to lean towards endorsing Barack Obama. That wouldn't surprise me.
If that happens, Robert, how much will it mean?
I think, General Powell is very well respected by a lot of people, and that, you know, one of the issues that Republicans have used against Barack Obama is questions about his foreign policy or his military acumen, and that the association with Colin Powell might help there. But I think, you know, Barack Obama is doing well on his own.
All right. We're going to touch a lot of bases. Michael, in any ways you see McCain-Palin reflecting Reagan-Bush?
Oh, no. I mean,
not at all.
Not at all. I mean, McCain-Palin is so much different than Reagan-Bush. It was a different time. It was a different era back in the 1980s, and it is here in 2008. There's a lot more media today than there was back in 1980. Ronald Reagan's demeanor, a lot different than John McCain's. You know, he was a great storyteller, my father. So when asked a question in a debate, he could tell a great story and get his point across, where John McCain really isn't that great of a storyteller.
Staying family for a minute, Robert, any way we can compare Obama to your father or your uncle?
I think he's very similar in his disposition to my uncle, to John Kennedy. He has the same kind of coolness and detachment. I think his deep concern for issues like justice and poverty, the passion that he has for those things is reminds me of my own father.
Okay.
If I could say something,
sure.
I mean, I've never got a chance to say this before, to thank a Kennedy, but there's a difference between Obama and John Kennedy, and one of the big differences is that Barack Obama wants to tax me. When I was a kid, my dad used to give me a buck a week, and he told me one time that if there's a president that ever gives him a tax break, he'll give me an increase in allowance. John Kennedy gave my dad a tax break back in the 1960s, and my dad raised my allowance from $1 to $5. Barack Obama wants to take that $4 away.
But he denies that. Why do you keep saying it?
What?
Barack Obama, he said 95% of the public will get a tax cut. Why? He's lying?
Because, yes, in a matter of fact, he's being disingenuous because about 40% of the public now doesn't pay taxes. So the only way you can give them a tax cut is give people money who aren't paying taxes at all. So you're going to send them a check. We normally call that welfare when we send somebody a check.
Well, it seems to me that the Republicans have done that in their history as well. Send a lot of people checks.
Well,
I mean, they
send people checks like...
Yeah, like recently when the government had...
Well, I think this bailout, is outrageous, the bailout. And what I think is outrageous really about it, Larry, is the fact that, you know, I said this to a couple of members of Congress, that within the bailout package, none of the regulations, none of the laws that were in effect that helped Congress... in fact go this direction, or the banks go this direction, were in fact rescinded in the bailout bill. I think that's outrageous.
Bobby, let's discuss the article you've written in Rolling Stone. Allegations of, are you fear a lot of voter fraud coming? I know that today the Supreme Court went on your side and sided with Ohio's top election officials in a fight with the state Republican Party over voter registration. The judges overruled a lower court ruling that ordered Ohio Secretary of State to do more to help counties verify voter eligibility. What are your concerns?
Well, the voter eligibility issue really is it's a sideshow, Larry, and all of this stuff that we've heard recently about Acorn falsely registering people. It's really not an issue in our country over the past, since 2002, there's been 270 million people have voted, and there's only been 24 proven cases across the country of actual voter fraud. The stuff that Acorn was involved in really was people who were working for Acorn defrauding Acorn. You hear these stories about somebody filing 18 different registrations for the same person. Well, there's actually nothing illegal about that. You can file as many registrations as you want. It's only the last one that counts. And that, you know, they have Mickey Mouse registered or whatever. But Mickey Mouse is not going to vote. It's really, you know, those people who were falsely registered. It was people that Acorn hired that they were paying per registration that went to a phone book and just copied down names or made up names and then collected their money from Acorn. But none of those people are actually going to show up and vote. You know, David Iglesias, who was the prosecutor, was the U.S. attorney under the Bush Justice Department for the state of New Mexico, was ordered by his boss, Alberto Gonzalez, and by the Karl Rove machine in the White House to go out and prosecute voter fraud because they wanted to gin up this hysteria about it. He looked for 2 years. They gave him 100 names off of Acorn list. He was not able to find a single case in New Mexico of anybody ever showing up and trying to vote twice or vote under somebody's name. It's just not something that happens.
Let me get a break. We'll come right back.